the comeback. We love stories like that. We love it in sports when there's a team that's down and it looks like that their opportunity to win is unlikely, and then they come back. And how many of us are ready for the comeback? We're ready to rebound. We're ready to get back where things maybe used to be. We feel like, oh, I want to be back there again. The past was tough. Yeah, the past is tough, but we're going to look ahead. We're going to look forward, as Paul challenged us in Philippians. In chapter 3, verse 12, he says, I don't mean to say I've already achieved these things, or that I've already reached perfection. Has anybody already reached perfection? Okay, no, nobody brave enough to admit it. You're like, I would raise my hand, but I want to make everybody feel bad around me, you know? He said, I haven't achieved perfection just yet, but I press on. I press on. I move forward. I press on to possess the perfection for which Christ Jesus first possessed me. No, dear brothers and sisters, I haven't already achieved it. You know, many people will come and talk to me and think that I've got my whole life together. I don't have it. I haven't achieved it. And Paul's saying, I haven't achieved it all either. I haven't achieved it all. I'm still moving forward in my life. I still have issues in my life because I have not achieved it, but I focus on this one thing. And if there's one thing that we can focus on in the new year, it's this one thing. What does it say there? Forgetting the past and looking forward to what lies ahead. Underline that in your notes. Forgetting the past and looking forward to what lies ahead. I'm going to focus all my energies on this. Forgetting the past and looking forward. I press on to reach the end of the race and receive the heavenly prize for which God, through Christ Jesus, is calling us. Let all who are spiritually mature agree on these things. And if you disagree on some point, I believe God will make it plain to you. Verse 16 says, but we must hold on to the progress we have already made. Underline that. We must hold on to the progress that we've already made. He said, I'm going to focus on forgetting the past and looking forward to what's in front of me. I'm going to move forward. I'm not going to let my past define me. I'm not going to let my past hold me back any longer. Whatever the cost, I'm going to focus on this one thing, moving forward. I'm not going to live in the past any longer. I'm not going to let it anchor me. I'm going to move forward. Because in your notes, resilience is the capacity to recover quickly from difficulties. Talking about being resilient, the capacity to recover quickly from difficulties. That's what Paul said. I'm not going to focus on the difficulties of the past. I'm going to be resilient. I'm going to push forward. I'm going to bounce back from disruption. I'm looking forward to what God has in front of me. But that last verse is interesting. It says, but we must hold on to the progress that we've already made. It says, forget the past, but don't lose hold of the progress that you've already made. Some of you have made progress in your life. But did you hold on to it? You know, so many people in this past year, they lost the progress they had made. They didn't hold on to it. Maybe they were battling recovery and doing really well. And then chaos broke out, tragedy struck, and they didn't hold on to the progress. Maybe they were fighting for restoration in their life, but they didn't hold on to the progress. Maybe they were building good habits. Maybe you had some good habits that you started, you know, back as your New Year's resolution of 2020. We all make these New Year's resolutions. I'm going to start a new habit. And 2 weeks later, we're like, oh, I didn't say that. I'm pretty sure I didn't say that. You know, he's saying, don't lose hold of the progress that you've already made. Maybe you were, you know, reading scripture on a regular basis, attending church, doing the 5-5-5 challenge, which we challenge people to do, which is reading scripture for 5 minutes, praying for 5 minutes, and listening for the voice of God for 5 minutes. Maybe you started down this path and you were beginning to develop a good habit, and then life kind of got derailed and we let go of these things. Calamity hit and you lost your progress. This happens with dieting a lot. You start doing well. Oh, I'm making some progress. I'm losing some weight. I'm feeling better. You know what? I deserve to give myself a little bit of a break here. I've done so good. I deserve it. And before long, we've put on all that weight back again because we lost the progress. We let go of the progress. You know, if you're alive, you will face some adversity. You know, you will face some difficulties and some trials and some trouble. But resilient people who are resilient, understand that hard times will happen. That's why they're not caught off guard when it does happen. That's why they're able to bounce back quicker than other people, because they were looking, saying, I'm pretty sure some bad things are going to happen. Let me prepare myself for it in advance.